room. I had to kind of rearrange things today. It's one of the challenges of trying to shoot a workout video when you live in a small one-bedroom apartment. Today's workout has a fun structure. We're going to be building exercise combos. So we start with a really simple movement for 30 seconds, and then every 30 seconds, we're going to make it a little more complex. So for the arm section, just to give an example, it starts just a basic hammer curl. After 30 seconds, we're going to add on a lift, so it's a curl to a lift. After another 30 seconds, we'll add on a rotation open, so curl, lift, rotation. So all of the combinations kind of build like that. They start simple and we end with a four-part movement. You have five of those combos, and then we'll finish the workout by doing all of our completed combos back to back. Confused? Don't worry, I promise it'll make sense as we go through the workout together. For today's workout, you'll just need a set of weights. For some of the combos, we'll be using two. Others, they're optional. Some will just use one. But for the arm section, you need two weights, so make sure you have those. I'm using a set of 10-pound dumbbells, but scale up or down to match your fitness level. Each of the combos will take you a total of 2 minutes. So that's 2 minutes of continuous work, and then we rest afterwards while I show you what to expect from the next combo. Make sure that you warm up before doing this workout. I have a 5-minute warm-up on my channel. You could also do your own. Each of the combos kind of focuses on a different muscle group. The first one though will be total body, just so that we get everything moving. I'm gonna preview that right now, and then we're gonna get right to it. For this first combo, we're building up to kind of a variation of a burpee, I guess, but it's just going to start with a weighted squat. If both weights is too heavy, then you can always just use one, hold it at center chest. Let's go. So for these squats, I want you to have your feet a little wider than hips distance apart. It's going to make the next part of the combo a little easier. As you lower down in the squat, think of starting the movement by sliding your hips back. This way, your knees don't jut out further than the toes. So next up, guys, we're going to add in a jump back to a plank. Weights come down to the floor, jump your feet out to a plank, jump them back out wide, you're in a low squat, bring the weights to your shoulders, stand it up. So we have 30 seconds in this, and then we add on again. The next thing we'll add on is a renegade row at the bottom. All right, so now we add on a row at the bottom. Down, jump back to plank. You want to row right, left, and then come up. When you stand up, I don't want you to stand up and then bring the weights to your shoulders. I want you to stay low, bring them to your shoulders, and then drive up. All right, guys, now we add in a push-up. Row, row, push-up, struggle bus, and up. Last 30 seconds. And done. All right, so first combo is done. Now we are going to move on to the second. I'll preview that now while you catch your breath. Crunch with a skull crusher, so just showing the triceps a little love as well during this ab section. So start laying on your back, press your belly button down towards the floor, hold the weight overhead, knees stacked over hips. Now, as we do a skull crusher with the arms, toes are going to tap the floor, and then you're going to lift back up. So it's just a little tap and a lift. Little tap with the toes, lift. When you lift them up, I only want you to lift them so that the knees are stacked over the hips. Don't bring them all the way in here. It might seem like bigger is better, but when we curl the knees into our chest, it actually makes it easier, if you don't want. Next up, guys, let's add in a leg extension. So you're gonna lower down, up, extend the legs out, and in. Lower down, little lift, extend, bring them back. Now check in, is your low back peeling off the floor? We have a natural curvature to the spine, and you want to keep that, but I don't want you to feel any strain in the low back. All right, guys, now we add a leg lift. So you extend, you're going to lift up to 90, lower to a hover, bring in, start from the top. All right, last piece to the puzzle when you do that lift. Add in a little crunch. You're gonna reach your weight up towards your toes, get your shoulder blades off the floor, lower down, bring it to center. Extend out, lift up, little crunch at the top, lower back down. And done. Okay, now we are going to move on to arms. We're gonna start with a hammer curl in just a few seconds. Roll your shoulders down, chest open, abs in tight, soft bend to your knees. Palms face in towards each other. Let's go, hammer curl. So when we do standing arm work, sometimes we have the tendency to kind of shift the strain into our low back. If you lock your legs out, notice what happens. My butt is kind of sticking out, like I'm twerking or something, and then notice that arch in my back. You don't want that. You want a soft bend of the knees, abs in tight, so it should look like that instead. We're gonna start adding in a bent lateral raise. So you're gonna curl in just to 90. Now you're gonna lift your elbows up wide to the side, lower them back down, and then straighten the arms. So curl just to 90, lift up, lower, lower. When you do that lift, I don't want you to scrunch your shoulders up to your ears. So think tops of the shoulders away from the ears. The next add-on coming up will be a rotation up. So curl to 90, lift the elbows, rotate those palms up so you're in goalpost arms at the top, reverse it, rotate down, lower the elbows, lower the hands. So you're hitting 90 degree angles. Keep it sharp. We have just one add-on to go, and it'll be a shoulder press. So curl to 90, lift to 90, rotate open, press overhead, reverse it. Check in, soft bend of the knees, keep your abs in tight. Rotation, open and close, is the hardest for me. And done. Okay, on to legs. I'm going to use one weight held at center chest. If you're feeling like a badass, you could use both, hold one at each shoulder, or you can absolutely do this one just body weight. So pick your poison. Let's go, curtsy lunge. and we're gonna add in a kick at the top. So you sink down low and kick. The focus is going to be the stationary leg. After these first 30 seconds, we'll add in a center squat. Okay, so now we kick up, come down, come to center, back to the curtsy. So, whoop, almost tripped myself. Staying low, center, curtsy, kick. All right, now we add in a jump squat. Center, land softly, back to the curtsy. Squat center, jump, back to the start. If you need to modify, guys, take out the jump. So you would just come center, rise up. Okay, last add-on is going to be a back lunge. Last 30 seconds. Oop, lost track. There we go. Center, jump, back lunge to the start. Kick, curtsy, center, jump, back. And done. Okay, now we gotta do that on the second leg. So take a second to shake out. Whew, and catch your breath. All right, so same exact thing, but now the left leg is the focus. So mirroring me, left leg will be still. We'll start with that curtsy to the side kick. I will try not to take out my leg by nailing that bowl. Let's go. Curtsy, side kick. And again, you can pick the weight. I'm using one held at center. I'll be very impressed if you do both weights, one at each shoulder, especially during that jump squat. And this would be a great one to do body weight if you need to tone it down a notch. So next up, guys, to this sequence, we add in that squat. So you kick up, come low, come to center, back to curtsy. The goal is to stay low in that. So notice I'm not straightening this leg ever. Curtsy, center, still low, curtsy. Okay, now we add in that jump squat. My legs are burning. If you need to modify, don't jump. Just drive up. And this combo is a little tricky. If you mess it up, do not sweat it. Just hop back in. My kicks are getting lower and lower. Kick. All right, last add-on, we have that back lunge. So after you do your jump, stay low, back lunge, come to center. Oh no, sorry, go to the curtsy. So it's curtsy, center, jump, back lunge to the start. And done. Okay. Okay, we finished this workout with a 5-minute push. We're going to do each of those combos for 60 seconds. So again, we're doing the completed combo. The sequence that we were doing the last 30 seconds of each of those combos, that's what we're doing now. I'll walk you through it. Don't worry if you don't remember any of it. We are going to start with the squat to a plank with a renegade row and a push-up. We have 60 seconds of that. You're going to grab both weights. We start in 3, 2, 1, and let's go. So weights at shoulders, squat down, weights to the floor. Plank, row right, row left. Give me a push-up. Reverse it. Oh man, push-ups are definitely something I need to work on. We have 20 seconds to go, guys. Ab combos coming up next. Okay, so we're gonna lay down. We have that suitcase crunch with a skull crusher. Toes tap, lift them up, extend the legs out, lift, give me a crunch at the top. And if you mess up any part of this, guys, don't sweat it. Maybe just do one or two parts of it. I get it. It is kind of a lot to remember. Okay, on to arms. So you're going to need both weights. Hammer curl to 90, lift wide, rotate open. Shoulder press. Remember, when you do these, I want you to make sure that you have a soft bend to your knees and that you're holding your abs in tight. Hitting those sharp 90 degree angles. 90, 90, 90, straight. Seconds to go. Okay, down to one weight, we're going to isolate the right leg. So, curtsy, kick, whoop, curtsy, center squat, jump, back lunge. If you're lost, guys, just do part of it. Maybe you just focus on the curtsy kick. Woo, lost my balance. When you do the curtsy, guys, make sure that your knee is still tracking in line with your toes. I'm guilty of this. Don't let it dip all the way out to the side. Ooh, right into the other leg. Last 60 seconds. Let's do it. Curtsy, kick, curtsy, center squat, jump, back lunge. Get low in that back lunge. So I don't want you to hit your knee on the floor, of course, but do get it pretty low. Seconds to go. You can do it. Done. And that is your workout. So today has had a lot of kind of complicated movements going on. There was a lot to remember. So if you messed up, don't sweat it. I even messed up a couple times and I made the workout. This would be a great one to do again, to revisit maybe next week or in a couple days, because the more you do it, the more familiar you will get with those sequences, and they are really effective sequences when done correctly. So this one is worth coming back to if you kind of felt a little out of place while going through it this first time. Leave me a comment down below with any feedback you have, and if you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. For more workouts, you can visit my blog, pumpsandiron.com, and I will see you guys here next week.